Cheat.
Name Cheat. I don't know.
Yeah. Real love, shawty G'd up. Got me bugging, I don't think that I can leave her. Let them hate, they ain't getting in between us. Hold this Gucci, match the Gucci on your sneaker.
And everything that we do stays between us. So when we touching different loving, be my teacher. You hold me down, this ain't your crease, but you my piece, yeah. Take out your weave and make you smart and give you D, yeah. I'ma give my all, I'ma give my all, yeah. Even when you sleep, you still looking good, yeah. Take you out.
Hi guys, welcome back to our channel.
What's up everybody? If you guys are new to this channel, don't forget to click that subscribe button and give us a big what, babes?
Give us a big thumbs up and don't forget to turn on that notification bell.
Yes guys, we're also giving away post notification shout out at the end of our video. So if you guys want a post notification shout out, all you gotta do is comment down below, turn on the notification bell. Mm-hmm. Right, turn on the notification bell and you can be the lucky one to get a post notification shout out at the end of our videos. Now today guys, we are back with another challenge. If I can say it's a challenge, babes, what is it?
I think it's more like a Q&A.
Type of
Q&A. Yeah, it's more like a Q&A.
Like it's a type of Q&A where guys are afraid to ask girls and girls are afraid to ask boys.
Questions. But yeah. They really want the answers, but they are so afraid to ask them. But today, we're going to ask those questions, and you're going to answer, and vice versa, because we are not scared to ask those questions.
Yes, guys, we actually have a few questions we want to ask, so it's deep questions, and yeah, we're going to be as honest as possible. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, so stay tuned, give us a big thumbs up, and comment down below what you think about the video. Okay, let's get straight into it.
Are you ready for this?
Yes, I'm ready. Are you?
Always.
Okay,
always.
You guys ready? Let's go.
Okay, first question. Why are guys so afraid to show feelings?
Afraid to show feelings? Why are guys just afraid to show feelings, guys? Help me out with this one, but I think that guys are afraid to show feelings because they try to hide a lot of emotions, you know. You know, us as guys think we are so tough, but we're fighting that...
they are actually real babies.
That, yeah, we're actually babies, guys, but we try to be tough. And then, I think that's why guys are afraid to show feelings because they think they're tough. And although they're not tough, they have feelings. But I just want to...
They hide it very good.
They just want to hide it. But yeah, not that I say it's not... It's not fine to show your emotions. You have to show your emotions. And but guys think they are very tough, so...
I think it's actually cute when a guy shows their emotions. It makes you more of a man than hiding them.
Okay. Right, next question.
Next question. Why do guys like to check out other girls' butt?
I think that is just a guy thing, you know.
I think it's something that's like built in them. They don't intend to look at it, but it's just like, it's part of who they are. They just want to go.
Yes, it's just in the neck, guys.
In the nature of a guy that's like, oh, but, they don't mean to look, but it's just like the habit of theirs.
But yeah, coming to that question, this probably happens a lot to guys, that if you're with your girl in the mall and you're looking at the other girl, it's like your neck are stiff. You want to look, but you can't look because your girlfriend are with you. But yes. That is just...
So now I have like a... It's not part of the questions, but I want to know. So, in a case where you are like taller than your girlfriend, do you look? Because she can't see. She's like short, so now you can like look anywhere you want to look.
No, I don't think that, but... I think... that guys... They attend on looking at girls, but Yeah, I think it's when you when you're in a relationship like me, I don't care about looking at other girls, you know,
bottoms.
I don't mind because I have my own girlfriend. So yeah, that's it's pretty interesting, different.
Okay, follow up question. How does it feel when you are like out with your girl and she's looking good and what, and another guy stares at her? How does it make you feel?
I don't think it's a problem because, you know, we're all looking at each other. We're all looking at, you know, if you, if someone look good, obviously a lot of people are going to look at you. So for me, it doesn't, I don't care. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't bother me, you know. So if we're in a mall, obviously everyone will look, you know, it's part of nature. And yeah, it's... So yeah, that's my answer, and I won't get angry or anything.
Start a fight for no reason,
guys. And if it was in a situation where the guy comes to her and, you know, giving a compliment or asking a number, what the case may be, you know, that's only for me, eh? So yeah, then I'll probably bust out and yeah, I'll probably get a different reaction. So yeah.
Okay.
Come on, what you guys think, what you guys will do, but that's my honest
opinion.
Answer and opinion.
Okay, next question. Okay. When it's that time of the month, do you get like a smell from girls? I know this is awkward, but you know, do you get a smell or do you smell anything funny when you're close to the girl or?
No. I don't know. First of all, I don't know how it smells, so I don't get any. I've never gotten any like funny smell, and I don't know when she is on her period or yeah.
When is that time of the month?
And that time of the month, so I don't usually put my mind on smelling stuff or what the case may be, but I don't smell anything, so. Yeah, I think by that question is girls, when is that time of the month? Do you know how to, you betterly, you better, sorry, you better know how to look after yourself and how to clean up yourself, because I don't think any guy want to smell.
Get that funny smell.
Get that funny smell or anything, so.
Okay.
Yeah, that's just nasty.
Next question. What makes a man scared to commit to one girl and one girl only?
I think that come to that question is that, you know, like guys probably don't give 100% commitment to the girls because they fear that the girl don't give 100% to them.
Mm-hmm.
So they are like scared to
fully committed,
to be fully committed, you know, because they don't know how girls are. You can be madly in love, you can be, you know, she could be madly in love, but you don't know along the way what's gonna happen. You know, like I've watched a few documentaries of some of the famous people, you know. Somewhere along the line, things happen, you know, and like coming to a question is, for instance, that say, for instance, I lose interest in Astrid, and then she's like, she keep me away from all the things, all my friends or all my girlfriends.
The things we were used to before we were in a relationship.
Yes, the things I was used to before a relationship, she keep me away from that, and then obviously when the relationship is in long term, she just bust out and become someone else, or you know, are used to things that she are not used to doing with me. So I don't know if that answers your question, but that's I think that's why the commitment of a relationship are like in a long term a downfall or something like that. That answers your question.
Okay. Next one, why do men cheat?
men cheat? I don't know. I think it, like, coming to the previous question.
Is it like, do we give them too much attention? Do we give them not enough attention? Are we too clingy? Are we not clingy enough? Like, what's the reason that things like this happen? From your point of view, what do you think?
I think, like, in the previous
question. They get bored, maybe?
Bored. I don't think bored plays a
I think role. More that they are looking for a challenge, because now it was a challenge to get you, but now they have you, now they're looking for a new challenge. Maybe that
can be a reason. Maybe that is your question, because you answer everything. Yeah. So yeah, I don't know what to say anymore. But yeah, I don't know.
He doesn't know.
He's because I'm trying to say something, and you're like just busting in.
Okay, so answer.
It's just that, like I said in the previous one, it's maybe a lack of a commitment. You know, you know, losing, like in the previous, losing interest. It's like somewhere along the line in your relationship, you're not as loved as you were at day one. So the longer you see in each other, the longer you in each other's face, I think that that plays a big role. And you know, that's why me and Esther, that's why we are free to each other. When I want to go to my friend, she let me go. She's not that uptight, keeping me like
at home, you're just not going nowhere.
In her face, or what the case would be. I think that plays a big role of being in each other's face the whole time. I think there's space going out, or, you know, respecting each other's space plays a big role.
Mm-hmm.
And then, yeah, but I think guys cheat also because of, you know, they think they have the girlfriend or they have their wives and everything. They're still in love with their wives. They still love their wife, but they want to try like something different, you know. Not to say that they don't love their wives. Like, that can answer your question. Not to say that guys don't love the woman. They just want to go do something else, you know. And then if they get caught, it's like, it's back to square one. It's like they're all over in love again and everything.
All the feelings come back,
you know. It's like the first day you met each other.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that can answer you guys' question. Yes.
Okay, next one. Next question. Why don't most guys want to say I love you first?
I think they want to play it, you know, because when you meet a girl, you don't just say I love you, you know. You have to like do things together, commit to each other, you know, find each other's rhythm, if that can answer your question. You know, do things together, getting each other's reactions on what is right, what is wrong, how do you like it, how do you don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, guys take time to say I love you, because I think they're looking at all that situations, you
all
know,
the
and all the options, because you can't just say to a girl that you love her and you don't know the girl. So yeah, just like taking your time, step by step until it's the right time, and then from there on you guys take that. That is why I think that guys are taking so long, or that is what I think guys are taking
it's
so long.
It's just his opinion.
It's just my opinion. I don't know what you guys think. So if you guys think anything else, comment down below and give us your answers, guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
Your last question.
Yeah.
Why? After you now have the girlfriend, why do guys stop making effort? Like, before the relationship, it was like flowers, dates, all those things. Now you're in a relationship, it's dead. It's like a graveyard. Nothing.
It's like, it's not like for me personally, it's not like when you have the girlfriend, you're doing more effort or you give more effort. I think it's like more, I think like more of a long-term relationship, you know. I think that it's not about the flowers anymore. It's not about the eating out every weekend. It's not about the, it's about our future. Mm-hmm. You understand? So, for me, spoiling you the whole time and taking you out the whole time, you're also going to get boring. So, now I have to switch it up and say that, all right, I want to take it to the next level. I want to work my butt off. I want to do something else. It's now about the house. It's now about family and everything. It's not about, it's planning for the future. It's not about you, just you anymore. You understand? So mm-hmm. I think that is where a couple has to sit down and say, okay, it's not about all this nice stuff anymore. It's about our future. So we don't have to go out often, like every time. We have to like sit together and speak about our long-term relationship. Yeah.
It was a mouthful, but I hope you guys took it in and listened to what he said.
Yeah, right. This is deep, but it's cool.
It's deep. All right, so.
Are you done?
Yes. Okay. So now it's.
Comment down below what you think, guys. Don't forget to give us a big thumbs up.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, let's move on to Astrid.
Alright.
Do girls expect honest answers when asking a guy, do I look fat?
I would expect you to be honest. Like, there's a reason why I ask you, do I look fat? So that I can go change, if it's like yes, and put on something more suitable for my body. There are girls that ask you that question just to boost their ego. So they want you to lie and be like, no, you look good. They're just fishing for compliments.
Okay.
But in my opinion, I want you to be honest.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Why can't you guys decide where you want to eat when guys tell you you can eat out? Like when guys ask you where you want to eat tonight or something like that.
Girls, just comment down below, because this is my answer. I have a lot of reasons, but yeah, first, that day I might be in the mood for like one of each thing of a place. I might want the juice there, I want the chips there, or I want the meal, a burger there. So you can't ask me where I want to eat, but I want to go to three different places. And then the other thing that guys always forget, we girls don't know your budget. So now you tell me I must choose where we must go to eat, but then we go to a place and then your budget says no, we can't go eat out there. So if you ask that, you must tell me this is the budget, or just tell you can choose any place, don't worry about paying, then I'll know I can go anywhere. But now you just ask where do you want to go eat, so I have to think about your budget as well. Yeah.
Okay. So next time, guys, you just say you can choose any place. Okay. So that she knows.
Right? Be specific when you ask that question. Explain your question so we know.
Okay. Next question. Why do girls go to the bathroom in a group? Yeah, I also want to know. I think I've got
just comment down below. Tell them why we go to the bathroom in group. It's like a secret. We can't tell you why we go to the bathroom. Okay. So, first of all, we go for safety. Especially when we're at a club. Guys don't always want to go and stand outside the bathroom and wait for us. So, it's for safety. You take a friend with you. So, when something happens, there's someone to protect you or to run out and call for help. The other reason is, some girls, they share makeup, and then the obvious one is the gossip.
Okay, gossip. gossip is the main one. But anyway, let's move on. Describe the feeling. Oh no, it's not. That's not that one. Why do girls wear so much makeup?
I don't know, guys. I don't know why girls wear a lot of makeup. So, if you're one of the girls that wear makeup, please comment down below. But I think the reason why they wear makeup is just they love it. It makes them feel good. They do it for themselves. I'm not sure.
Okay.
So yeah, if you wear makeup, comment down below. Tell us why you love to wear makeup.
Too much makeup. Yeah, too much makeup. Comment down below. Okay, that's just the.
Or maybe they have like acne. They want to cover up. I don't know.
Okay.
I put on some lotion and then I'm gone.
All right. Describe the feeling when you are on your period.
Okay. The feeling when you're on your period. So for most girls, it's like you get different feelings. So to make it easier to explain to you is like when someone kicks you there, times it with 10.
Ooh, that's
the feeling we get.
Yo, that's very, very sore.
It is. So some of the girls,
painful.
From the waist down, they get numb. That's how bad the feeling gets.
Okay. That's very, very sore. Kicking someone in their balls.
Times 10.
Ooh, that happened a lot to me in the rugby games. But anyway.
The one time is already hard enough.
Okay, next question. Why do girls wait to reply on a message? Especially the first day you met.
We don't want to seem too eager, like, I don't want to show this guy I'm into him. So we wait, we play it cool, we trying to ease into everything. We don't want to go bam, reply, and then you're like, no, this girl is too easy, let me just move on to the next one.
Yeah,
we want you to work.
But you know, coming to that question, guys, it's like you met last night, you had a good time, and now we guys, we feel like sending like a text message and there's no reply for like 1 or 2 days, but we had a good time. So it's like we don't understand what's going on. Are you guys trying to test us or what the case would be? But like you said, now it's just like you're taking it with emotion.
Yeah, but the thing
you
is,
don't want to be over.
If we met in the club, so obviously we are thinking, I'm not the only girl you spoke to. So you have like a list of girls, say for instance, so you're gonna wait.
Okay.
You will work. If it's worth it, you will work.
Okay. Cool. Next one. Why are girls afraid to say they are going to the bathroom or going to do number two? Right. Why are you guys afraid? Tell us. Please tell us. I want to know. Guys, comment down below if you want to know, because girls are very afraid to say that they are going to the bathroom to do number two.
First of all, I'm not afraid. I will let you know. I was afraid. When we started dating, I didn't tell him I'm going there because I just feel shy. Like, you don't need to know my business. What I do in the bathroom is my business. So that's just how I feel. How I felt when we started dating, but now he knows too much of my business.
Okay. Okay, last question. When girls have mood swings, do they want space or not? Comment down below. Let me hear what you have to say.
In my case, it's like a 50-50. I want my space, but I also want the attention. Just so I know, okay, the guy still cares, but then you just need to be out of my face. If that makes sense.
Okay.
So it's like a 50-50 thing. Leave me alone, but also love me at the same time.
Okay. Yeah, guys, so now I also know something, because yeah, when we argue, it's like we don't speak for like a day or two.
Now you know.
So now I know, just do something to make her laugh and then go.
Or like,
just wait.
Or in this case, drink something or do something nice for me. It doesn't have to involve money or anything. And then just leave it and then you disappear.
Okay. Make some tea, make some coffee.
Yeah. Make some tea.
Make some popcorn. Yeah. You know, just do something nice.
Put it
you
there.
Don't have to go out of the way to go and buy
or make me a sandwich.
Or make a sandwich.
And then you just leave it and you disappear.
Okay. Now I know. Yes, guys, so that is the end of the video.
Mm-hmm.
we enjoyed it. It was quite deep.
It was.
But yeah, we hope you answer your questions.
And if you guys have more questions, don't be shy. Comment down below and we will ask those questions and answer them for you guys. What
Definitely.
We think.
Definitely.
So yeah, don't be shy. Comment.
Yes, guys. So if you have some comments, we will be doing a next video for you guys. So anything you have on your heart, specify with your partner, spell it out. We will do it for you. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Give us comments. I have Instagram. Ashley doesn't have Instagram. She has Facebook. So go follow her on Facebook. Go follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I'm going to put it down in the link for you.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, go follow us, give us some questions, DM, prank questions, any questions you want.
Not only prank questions, but if you have prank ideas, yeah. Anything, don't be shy, guys. We're actually very nice. We don't bite.
Definitely.
You not might, bite. But I won't.
All right, guys, that brings us to the end of the videos. We said we're giving away post notification shout-out at the end of our video, so today's post notification shout-out goes to the babes. Let's check. Today's post notification shout out goes to Eric Smith. Thank you very much, Eric Smith.
Thank you for all your love and support. Keep on supporting us. Tell your friends, your family, everybody about us. Let them also follow so they can also get a post notification shout out.
Yes, guys. Like Astrid says, you guys can get a post notification shout out. Join the family, man. Well, not the family, join the couple, because we don't have a family yet. But anyway, join the couple, the CH vlog, and yeah, help us grow. Okay, like me and my beautiful queen over here always say, we'll be back
with more videos.
Peace.